WB Montreal was dealt a terrible hand. With the success of Arkham Asylum and City, Rocksteady had a lot to think about when it came to following up some of the most praised modern-day superhero games. And the thing they needed the most was time. WB was willing to give that to them, but with the caveat of keeping the release schedule of a Batman Arkham game every 2 years. And with giving Rocksteady the time they needed to complete their trilogy, WB looked to their Montreal studio to fill in the gap and release a game in 2013. WB Montreal had only worked on smaller projects before being given the task of staving off hungry fans. So Arkham Origins was truly the moment for them to prove themselves as a full-blown studio. Unfortunately, it's hard to prove yourself when you're put into a box. Arkham Origins came out to a bunch of shrugs. It was the first game in the series that didn't make everyone's head turn. It felt like it just kind of came and went, and when people talk about the legacy of the Arkham series, I feel like Arkham Origins is frequently ignored. And while to many people, Origins came off as a jack of all trades, I do believe one aspect of the game that truly makes it special doesn't get talked about enough. And it's in the title, the true origin of Batman. Welcome to the third episode of the Arkham Files, a Kinda Funny Games miniseries where I, Barrett Courtney, look back at what made each game in the Batman Arkham franchise so special. Today, let's look back at the middle child of the series, Arkham Origins, and talk about the importance of discovering fear as Batman. So what was the reason for Origins always feeling like it got left behind? If we look at the game we got on a surface level, there are a few factors. The moment-to-moment gameplay and overall design felt like a copy of Arkham City, if the copier left a few smudges here and there. Arkham City stood out for how different it felt from Asylum, but Origins didn't really have that same level of innovation. Which is fine, City's gameplay was great, so why not just do it again? Again, the headspace WB was in was not to improve, or to even think about design philosophy on a deeper level tied to the ethos of Batman. It was just to get something out. It almost felt like a step backward from the level of detail that both Asylum and City had. Gotham itself feels kind of lifeless, which you could blame on only criminals hanging out during this winter storm, but there's just a lack of detail and imagination into fleshing out the city that made it very uninteresting to explore. That, mixed with half of the map being ripped from City during a time of year we've also seen before, and that fucking bridge. It's all of this and the truly uninteresting Enigma trophies that created the biggest sin of the game. Exploring around wasn't rewarding enough. And for those parts of the game being major parts, I do understand why Arkham Origins doesn't get talked about as much as the other games. Hell, it doesn't even get the other end of the discussions where people won't shut up about how much they hate it. It's seriously neither. It wasn't extraordinary on either end of the spectrum. It was fine, which does make it forgettable. In my video for City, I talked about the reason it was so special was how different it was from Asylum, and any lesser company slash developer would have just followed up Asylum with more Asylum. Here we got to actually see what more of the same in the series would look like, and it's underwhelming. People have concerns with Gotham Knights since WB Montreal worked on Arkham Origins, but we have to remember how constrained WB Montreal was. This was a prequel game in a universe and with gameplay design the team hadn't created themselves. They were put in a very constricting box, so there was only so much they could do. And while there isn't much to say about the gameplay elements of Origins, I do think there's one aspect that the game succeeded with that not enough people talk about, the story. WB Montreal were clear in the marketing for this game that while the game is called Arkham Origins, it wasn't the very beginning of Batman's career. He's not tripping over his cape, and he knows how to fight a group of baddies and not get overwhelmed. So, what's the origin story being told here, besides the silly origin of Arkham Asylum at the end of the game? It's the beginning of Bruce Wayne actually understanding who Batman needs to be. Every superhero has their growing pains. And for Batman, it's thinking he just needs to be better than his opponent. Whether that's in strength or knowledge, he needs to be ahead. And in the typical early days of Batman, his way of thinking works for the most part with the type of criminals he grew up with. But Batman's presence always invites a new class of criminal into Gotham. And in Origins, this new class of criminal is invited for one night to kill Batman. And that's where Bruce is shown how wrong he is about who Batman needs to be. With villains tougher like Bane and more clever and chaotic like Joker, Bruce is now fighting his war incorrectly. In this universe, young Bruce has been coming at his war against crime and Gotham from a place of anger. And while anger for people can be a major drive, it often makes us sloppy. You see that anger in Roger Craig Smith's performance, who I think is amazing as a younger Bruce in this game. He not only does a great job emulating a younger version of Kevin Conroy's Batman, he also plays the less mature Bruce, the Bruce who hasn't learned the key lesson yet, phenomenally. The most important key for Batman is fear. And while this younger Bruce is seen experimenting with how to use that against his enemies throughout the game, when we meet him at the beginning of Origins, he doesn't realize yet that fear needs to go both ways. Batman needs fear, not anger, to truly become the hero he needs to be. He tried so long shutting himself off from fear since the death of his parents, but he also shut himself off from the feeling of what it's like to lose. And throughout Origins, we see Bruce go on that very important journey of being reminded that he also needs fear to truly keep him driven and to constantly remind himself how much he has to lose and how scary that really is. One of my favorite moments in the entire Arkham series is when Batman discovers Joker's hotel and sees for the first time what this new villain is capable of. We get hints of something grand about to happen when we first get into the hotel, but when we walk into Joker's demented carnival, Batman says,
"What is this?"
It's not much, but there always felt like a subtle hint of fear in Roger Craig Smith's performance that I absolutely love. That entire hotel sequence, Bane knowing Batman's identity and almost failing at taking down Firefly, reminds Bruce that he has so much at stake constantly, and he finally admits that he can't take on all of these fears alone. He finally accepts the help of Alfred and Gordon, and it's all inspired by his fear of losing to this new class of criminal. Especially when it crescendos into Alfred almost dying, Bruce is reminded of why he's doing this in the first place, and accepts that role Batman needs to have in Gotham and the headspace he needs to be in to succeed at that. Arkham Origins nails Batman's origin story. Like I said earlier, it's not the typical origin story of Bruce putting on the cowl for the first time, but it's the story of Bruce discovering what he truly needs to become Batman: fear. WB Montreal got the short end of the stick, being forced into a box to make something in a universe that wasn't fully theirs. But with the little tools they were given, they showed that they truly understand the important aspects of Batman. And it's because of Origins of why I'm excited for Gotham Knights. It's their own universe to play around in from a gameplay and design standpoint. And since they've already proven themselves story-wise, I'm confident that they're going to deliver a story that's truly special. And with Origins' release, Rocksteady was given the time to figure out how they wanted to end their Batman Arkham trilogy, which was a big question for everyone. I mean, you could continue the pattern the trilogy was going so far and go somewhere completely different with it, like what City did after Asylum, or you could end the trilogy by mixing together the best elements from the first two games to make it all come to a satisfying conclusion. Join me this Sunday on Halloween for the final episode of The Arkham Files, where we'll dive into Arkham Knight and how I think it's a masterpiece of an ending for the Arkham series. But until next time,
this is going to be fun.